Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making chicken tetrazzini. So let's start with a large bowl, and I've already put some cream of chicken soup in. I put two cans, just standard 10.75 ounce cans. To that I'm going to add 1½ cups of milk. And then for some nice flavor here, I'm going to add 1 cup of grated Parmesan cheese. Now this is that dry grated that you get in a can, and I don't use that all the time. I like to hand grate a lot of them, but in this particular case it really works out well because of the way it blends in with the milk and the cream of chicken soup. 1 cup. And you might find some of those that say Parmesan and Romano. That would be fine too. I have 1 teaspoon of onion powder. It's going in, and then I'm going to stir, just take a little break here and stir before I put more things in. I have quite a few things to go in here to make this a really tasty dish. I have this mixed together pretty well. It can have some lumps in it. It doesn't really matter. Those will melt out because that cheese actually does melt when it's heated, and we will be baking this in the oven. Now what I have right here are 3 cups of cooked chicken. You can obtain those however you like. You could go to your deli section in your supermarket and get a rotisserie chicken and just pull the meat off the bones, and you could get at least 3 cups. 3 cups is what I have. You can use canned chicken. You can go to the deli and have them slice off a huge slice, a thick slice we'll say, and then you could cut that into cubes. There are lots of ways of getting cooked chicken without having to go to a lot of work. But mine was done in a slow cooker overnight, and I just had chicken breasts that I salted and let them go overnight, and I just shredded them up, chunked them up until I had nice pieces to go in the casserole. Oops, there went one. It's not going in the casserole. I guess Remy will run in here and get it in a minute. He missed that. Now we're adding mushrooms. I have 1 cup of fairly finely chopped mushrooms. You can use your own judgment as to what size you want to chop them into. And some of you have written me about other recipes that have mushrooms and have said, do I have to use mushrooms? No, you don't. This, I think, makes it taste better, but if you don't think in that way, then just leave them out. It's not a problem. So we'll stir this just a little bit, because next item to add is vermicelli. This is 1 pound of vermicelli. Remy did make it in here. Did he find it, Rick?
Yep.
Can't do anything without Remy knowing about it. We have 1/2 pound, or 8 ounces, uncooked of vermicelli, but I cooked it using 1 teaspoon of salt, and we're going to add all of that in. You can use spaghetti if you'd rather. This is a big mixture, and that means we're going to use a fairly big pan or baking dish to bake it. Once I get this mixed, really it's ready to pour into my baking dish. I'm going to use a 13x9x2 inch Pyrex dish, and I've already sprayed it with cooking oil spray. So let's just go ahead and pour this in. And then there'll be a little topping, and then it will get baked. So here we have the pan, and I don't want to fill it over full, so if there's any spillover, I will just take another pan out, a small dish, and we'll have a little separate casserole for Remy. He's hunting around right now for anything that might have dropped. I think that was the only thing that I dropped. Start putting this in. Keeping an eye on the fact that it's a very big mixture, and this could be getting full. I don't think it's going to be a problem, really. Looks like it's doing fine. It smells really good. It's edible right now. I think I'd rather have those mushrooms cooked down. But other than that, it's just so great smelling. Can you smell it, Rick?
Oh, yeah.
I think it's that Parmesan cheese when it mixes with the liquid, mm-hmm. particularly the chicken, cream of chicken soup. It just makes it so aromatic. So spread this out. And then you can put whatever kind of topping you like on it. A lot of people like to use a herb crouton mix, something like that. I've decided to use Italian breadcrumbs. You could use plain breadcrumbs if you would rather, but I have over here 3/4 cup, but you could use 1 cup. This is very approximate. And I'm using 5 tablespoons of butter that I've melted. I just use the microwave to melt that, and I want to put these two together in such a way. I was going to use this little spoon, but I'm going to actually use my hands to put that on top, so I might as well start getting them dirty. Just let this go together so that this is crumbly. And then we'll have a nice topping that has some flavor that is Italian, and that brings this dish back a little bit to Italy because it is Tetrazzini. And even though I called it chicken Tetrazzini, you can make it turkey Tetrazzini if you would like to. Those are similar fowl, so it's just up to you. When you get this together, I like a lot of it, and you may like less. If so, you can divide that in half. But when you get it together, just start sprinkling it as evenly as you can. And this serves to seal in a lot of that good flavor, and it gives a great crunchiness to the top. Now we're going to a 400 degree oven, and we're going to let this bake. You can check on it occasionally, and when it appears done to you, take it out of the oven. I will keep track of the time though and let you know how long I left it in the oven. Here's our chicken Tetrazzini right out of the oven, and it took 25 minutes. It could have gone a little longer, but I didn't want this getting too brown on the top, so I just went ahead and took it out of the oven. So I'm coming over here to my place where I've got my tea ready to go. And this is going to be dinner for Rick and me. And remember, there is vermicelli in there. I did split it in half when I put it in the pot to boil, but you're going to have to remember that there are going to be strings as you bring this to your plate. So it's going to be a little stringy, but you can manage it. Just don't worry about it. So I want to get a lot of nice chunks of chicken in there and a little bit of crumb top. And I'm going to take a bite for you. I usually cut my spaghetti or vermicelli into little pieces. Rick usually twirls his. We always have to be different about something. But I see mushrooms in there, topping. I don't see any chicken right off. Let me get some chicken over there. And the chicken is as tender as it can be because of being done in a slow cooker first. Here we go. It's very hot, but I think I can take it. Mmm. This is a little out of the ordinary for Rick and me. We love Italian food. I wouldn't say this is that Italian, really, but it does have some components that you would say are Italian and a name that originates there. But I think Rick's really going to love this. I love it. Just right off, I can tell that it is a great dish. And one thing I would like to say is that some of you have been asking me lately for dishes that are economical and also dishes that will feed a lot of people, dishes that if you perhaps live by yourself, you could prepare the whole dish and then maybe freeze part of it
and get it out later and warm it up, that would be perfect on this one. And I think that you would enjoy eating it more than one time, so it's not like you'd be stuck with something forever that you hated. But I think it's just really good, and I hope you enjoy this new recipe.